Captain Lopez, reporting on Expedition 17B. At the formation now, visually, no distinction from the previous mission. Detecting.
Bye, Jesse. I should be going. Enjoy your data.
Oh, I will.
If they're in there, we go around that way.
Hey, I put extra security on your brother. No offense, but that dude is the scariest motherfucker I have ever laid eyes on. Like I said, though, no offense.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
Two squads lost. Christ.
Things were stabilizing. Marshall abandons us. I'm sick of no one telling us what's going on.
Information's always been on a need-to-know basis.
Well, I need to fucking know. I'm an upper-level executive, damn it.
Welcome back.
Never thought I'd be working in the executive sector. Look at me now, Ma.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know. I'll be seeing you.
They're endangering us by bringing a hiss in. The trench was still around, you stopped
us.
Nonsense to yourself.
Lots of errors on this form.
Did you see that hiss they marched through here? Why the fuck didn't we put a bullet in that thing's head?
I heard it's the director's brother. Would you shoot your brother?
That's no one's brother anymore. He's the enemy, plain and simple.
Oh.
matters, home disowns you. Happiness comes, white pearls, but yellow and red in the eye. Through a mirror inverted is me, right? Leave your insides by the door, push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been in here, you want this to be true. We stand around you while you dream. You can almost hear our words, but you forget. Through time, the thunder's home distorts you. Happiness comes, white pearls, but yellow and red in me. You are a worm through time.
Shit.
The thunder's home distorts you.
That's Dylan.
White pearls,
can you hear me?
Red in the eye.
Oh, come on, Dylan. I'm here. I found you.
You've always been in here. You want this to be true.
Do you know who I am? Oh, you know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
He's talking in the third person. Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan. Trench and Darling made sure of that. I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been the new you. You want this to be true.
Can you stop that? Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them. They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head. If he is still in there, if there is anything left, you have to help me.
You! You came in through the hole in you! We let you in, you've always been here! The only truth! A copy of a copy of a copy of a copy!
Stop it!
Orangefield!
Shit! Shit! He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister when we were very small. In ordinary. In the desert, through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away. She didn't give me any powers. All the powers are my own powers. She didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The air cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found... They opened the door up to the hiss. That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the altered world event in ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
An earworm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream. Baby, 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 yeah. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
I welcomed the hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The hiss set me free. Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the hiss.
Your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister. The horrible truth about the Bureau. The hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate program in the containment sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to have it.
Wanted? Bullshit. I saw what the hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this light projector. You can help me. We can end this.
You are a worm through time. You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes.
I don't know what else I'm hoping to find here.
Dylan. Can we talk?
I'd like to tell you about a dream I had last night.
Off to a good start.
Okay. I'm listening.
I was back in Ordinary, before all of this happened. But in the dream, I was alone. It was just me. I was the only child. A girl. My name was Jesse Dylan Faden. But then the Bureau came and caught me, brought me back here, locked me up. Have you ever noticed that our names, Jesse, Dylan, they could be girls' names, boys' names, could be anything. Don't you find that weird? I find that weird.
Sure.
What the hell was that? Is he trying to mess with me?
You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes.
Maybe Dylan's still in there. Maybe there's a way to reach him.
I'd like to talk to my brother, please. Dylan?
Dylan would like to tell you about a dream he had just now.
This again?
I was going to be the new director of this place. I helped you get a job here, so that we could be together. You were an office assistant. You'd make coffee and deliver the mail, and there was always plenty of work to do. And it stayed that way. Forever and ever. It was nice. Really nice.
That's debatable.
But here's the strange thing. The dream shifted, and none of it was real anymore. It was a game. We were in a game, and it was a fucking boring game. But you couldn't stop playing. And then it shifted again. Or maybe it was another dream already. Or maybe I'm just confusing them. But in this other dream, it was more like a musical. This is an ordinary song about an ordinary girl from an ordinary town. It's the ordinary story. She worked an ordinary job in an ordinary office and something, 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 something. And that's all I can remember of that dream.
Maybe that's for the best.
You are a worm through time. The thunder.
Maybe I can learn more about the hiss from him.
Can we talk?
I just had an interesting dream.
Shit.
That's fascinating, but let's talk about the hiss for a change, yeah?
This dream was about the hiss.
Best I'm gonna get.
In my dream, the hiss had broken free of this prison, this house. I'd set it free. And the president himself was there to welcome us. He was the first one to take the hiss in. Spread the word. At first, many people thought it was horrifying. That he was horrifying. But also, many people who heard his words wanted to welcome the hiss in. And slowly, more and more of them came around, until the whole world was brought together by the hiss. It was wonderful.
Okay. Thanks for sharing that.
For the record, that will never happen. Not as long as I'm alive.
The thunder song distorts you.
Maybe I'm just here to punish myself.
Any new dreams you'd like to share, Dylan?
I'm glad you asked, sister. This dream, like all dreams now, felt very real. Like reality. And reality now feels like a dream. Maybe it's all a dream. Maybe it's all real.
Dream where my brother endlessly tells me about his dreams.
I was in a dark place. And there was a dark man there. His name was Mr. Door. And he told me that there are many worlds. Side by side, on top of each other, some inside of others. In one world, there was a writer who wrote a story about a cop. In another world, the cop was real. Dor said he himself was in all of them at the same time, endlessly shifting between them. I asked him how I could reach these worlds. I wanted to bring the hiss there. But he didn't want to help me. He didn't like the idea. What did he know?
I'm not wild about the idea myself.
Through time, the thunder song distorts you.
Here we go again. Once more with feeling.
Let me guess. You want to tell me about your dream?
Yes. Yes. In fact, I'm having a dream right now.
Oh. That's new.
In this dream, I'm standing in the corner watching Jesse and Dylan talk about this very dream. This very dream! He said just now! And repeated it again now! I'm standing there and watching, and that's all I can do. It's as if I'm trapped there. And that's all I have to say about that dream.
Okay, okay, Dylan. That's good.
Is he still in there? Or is this the hiss playing mind games? I don't know.
Through a mirror, the inverted is made right. Leave your inside by the door. Push the thing through the surface into the way. You've always been near you. You want this to be true. We stand around you while you dream.
How are you doing, Jesse? It can't be easy seeing Dylan like this.
I'm fine. What can you tell me? Is he still human?
Or is he his?
I've taken numerous tissue samples and have tests running as we speak, but from the initial data, he looks healthy. I only see corruption in a superficial way.
What does that mean?
I don't know. This is all new. But if he's like you, maybe Polaris is preventing total hiss takeover. Or maybe this is just a new form of hiss. We've already seen how it affects people in different ways.
Dylan told me he let the hiss in. Does that change anything?
Voluntary conversion. I mean, hypothetically, that could affect the mental state post-corruption, as well as the extent of biological alteration. But again, this is new territory for me. I'll need time.
You won't have it. I'm gonna shut down the slide projector. That's how the hiss are getting in. Once I close it, this should all be over.
Jesse, we don't know how this works. If you sever their connection to the source, it could cause a terminal chain reaction. Every hiss-corrupted individual dead.
Better that than what Dylan is now.
I'm shutting it down. This has to end. Whatever happens, happens.
Okay, just let me know how I can help.
Thank you, Emily.
Bring me back anything good?
I've been seeing these Darling presentations all over. Seems like he enjoys the limelight.
So you noticed, huh? When he recruited me out of college, he actually came to visit. He interrupted my physics course by shouting, not quite, professor, and then marching down to the front of the class where he proceeded to berate the very idea of laws of thermodynamics. Hey, he's been a showboat all his life.
Darling visited you in college?
Yeah, he read a paper I'd published, came to recruit me for the bureau. I accepted and then spent years waiting for access to the confidential research that Darling promised me. And whenever I ask about my access level, he just mumbles that it's temporarily postponed and then changes the subject to the effect of entropy on luck.
I wonder who else Darling hid his work from. Marshall? Trench?
Have you learned anything about Dylan's condition?
Only that he's definitely his, but I guess his chanting made that pretty obvious. You know, interestingly, the words of the hiss incantation have an average length of 4 letters. The most common word used 7 times is want. The next most common are through and time. It's very interesting, don't you think?
I don't care about the words. What about my brother?
Right. Sorry, I got a little off track. Well, strangely, his tissue samples all look healthy, unlike the other hiss I've tested.
That's good news. Right?
I wanted to talk to you about the crazy things I can do. My abilities. I get the sense that they're not very usual around here.
Well, usual and unusual aren't really benchmarks at the Bureau, but for some perspective, Director Northmore once used the floppy disk to send a bowling ball 6 yards through the air, and that was considered a huge deal. So compared to that, you are most certainly an outlier.
An outlier. I like the sound of that.
I should get going.
Don't let me hold you up.
You need something? Lots of work to do. Let's get to it, okay?
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know. Hey, watch yourself out there.
our future. P7.
Thank you.
I can see you're upset, Meg. Why don't you tell Uncle Mr. Bones what's wrong?
I did bad on my clairvoyance test.
You can't ace every test, Meg. You see, everyone has different brains. Some brains can talk to each other. We call this ESP.
ESP?
Some brains can lift objects like a baseball. Talk about a fly ball, eh, Meg?
No interruptions!
So who cares if you fail your clairvoyance test? Maybe your brain can throw baseballs, or talk to dead people, or make friends blind. Once we know what your brains can do, we'll know what job to give you. And if your brains are just right, you'll get to sit in the big chair.
What if I don't want the big chair?
What if I don't want the big chair? That's why we're all here. Use those brains to listen for once, or the only chair you'll get in is the one with straps.
I wish things had gone differently in Ordinary for us. But wishing won't change things.
Ordinary.
Finding the projector
so
will.
Coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden. Prime Candidate 6. And the sister as well. Once we catch up with her, but the boy. So much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable.
There was an incident. Yes. Lost a valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter.
We need to find that projector. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me.
We used to play there all the time. Me and Dylan, and other kids as well.
They studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking.
I were both prime candidates. Experiments. Very different one, sure, but both in a cell of some sort. Am I out of the cell now, or is all this, the house and being just another cell? Who's really in charge?
Yeah.
We're going back home. Of course we are. It started there, and it's never gone away. There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby.
to America overnight, celebrating.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world, in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life, popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there is something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
Annual evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6. In a single word, decide the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling is out of the building today.
He's never out.
See what they have on ordinary. It's all here. Our home, our school, the woods, the dump. create that tomb? Is that where they keep it?
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes.
The whole landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable.
Thank you.
effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department, dimensional research in the research sector, transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next. disappearing ducks. Great.
Altered item number 52 AE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the brain. First, a low voltage electric shock.
Contact the janitor if you need to get through.
Broken? How many dead ends can this place have? We need to find Ati.
Thank you.
I should find the others. No, Artie.
Now this boy left, said the son of Annikki Tähti. My assistant will keep work in the glove and the house standing. Lomille lumps, holiday humps.
How can anyone even get out of here while the building's sealed? Let alone go on a holiday. Guess I'm about to find out.
Da 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 da